Welcome all of you for today's class. Last class mein we had covered increasing and decreasing and we discussed about monotonicity of a function. So abhi hum dekhte hain ki what we have for you in today's class. Of course we'll solve few questions on monotonicity and then we'll move on to the next topic. So let us begin with the few questions of the part that we had covered in the last class. So basically the question that we had left in the last class, we'll be doing some theory part, so which is basically the inequality part in the AOD. So you will get many questions like this, that is where you will be having few functions and for a certain duration you will be required to find out or prove actually whether this is greater than or not. An objective will be required to find out. For example, I'll give you a very basic and simple question. So in the inequalities you will be having a form, always in fact having a form where you will be encountering a situation fx greater than gx for x belongs to something, right? So what all of you have to do in the situation is fx, you assume a function which will contain both of these. For example, let us say you have seen hx equals, or you can take hx equals fx minus gx, f of x minus gx. Now what we are going to do with this is, as we have discussed, we'll be talking about increasing or decreasing in the inequalities. Now let us say that this h of x is increasing for the entire interval that we have been given. Right, let's say we have h of x, we prove it to be increasing. We'll find it out when we have the function in hand. We can differentiate it and prove that this is increasing or decreasing. So let us say that hx is increasing. So we have assumed for a while that hx is increasing. Now since hx is increasing, so this particular thing is very very important, that x belongs to what, right? Now if hx is increasing, now we are saying, let us say we have some x which is, let's say, greater than maximum times you will encounter the situation. I'm just giving you an example. X is greater than 0, right? Since it is increasing, we can easily say that with the definition of increasing function, h of x is greater than h of 0, right? If in case h of 0 happens to be 0, right? This is the kind of situation that you will encounter maximum times. So if, let us say, h of 0 is equal to 0, so it clearly implies that h of x is greater than 0 for x greater than 0. So basically the condition here also, that would be same, that is x greater than 0. So from here we can say h of x is this. So fx minus gx greater than 0, f of x is greater than g of x for x greater than 0. This is a particular example of 0 that I have taken. It can be x1. In place of 0, x equal to 0, we can have x1. So this kind of similar situation will arise in the question that I have given you in the last class, right? So try to follow this and try to attempt that question. Or else we can try to solve this question before that, then you can try that one. If we have, or let us say we have to prove that x is greater than sine x for x greater than 0. So try to apply this here and follow all these steps. In this case, we can have the direct assumption that h of x is this. So as you have done, h of x equals x minus sine x. Now let us try to differentiate, and we have covered the LCD part, so we know both of them are differentiable. So 1 minus cos x, which is greater than or equal to 0 always, right? This is increasing. So since this is increasing, let us again take x greater than 0. So for x greater than 0, h of x has to be greater than h of 0 since hx is increasing. So x minus sin x is greater than h of 0. So clearly h of 0 is 0. So we can say that x is greater than sin x for x greater than 0. This is what we can clearly say about this function. Now this is what we have to do in the question that we have in the homework, right? So now you can try to do that question which we had covered in the homework. So this is the question. Let us write down the derivative. So here, of course, you have assumed hx equals 2x sec x plus x minus 3 tan x. So h dash x is equal to, we'll apply the product rule, 2 sec x plus 2x. Yes, sec x tan x. And minus 3 secant square x.
Plus 1.
There is x also, yes. Minus 3 secant square x plus 1. Right. Now, from this, it is not very clear whether this will be positive or negative. Right. So as we discussed, if we take out secant square x common, the remaining terms will be sine and cos. It might be easy for us to find out what that is going to be, right? So in this case, it will be 2 and we'll get cos x plus 2x sin x plus cos square x and minus 3. So this will be the derivative. We know that this is positive and we have to worry about this. So just think whether using trigonometry, there will be a lot of problem because apart from the trigonometric functions, there is an algebraic function as well, right? So what you can do is you can take it as a different question and apply everything to this question that we have done here in this, right? Then you can find out whether this is positive or not. Let us, this was hx, let us say, we have fx. Fx equals 2 cos x plus 2x sin x plus cos square x minus 3. Now this is our fx. Now just try to think what we can do with this fx. We can differentiate also. We can differentiate this and then we can proceed. Now when you will proceed with this, you will come to know that this is a question within the question, actually, right? So f dash x will be equal to minus 2 sin x plus 2 sin x. Then we have plus 2x cos x plus, in fact, minus 2 cos x sin x, and derivative of minus 3 is 0. This and this are gone. You have 2 cos x, and then inside the bracket, you need to have x minus sin x. We have just now covered the question that when x is positive, x minus sin x is positive. From 0 to pi by 2, cos x is already positive. In fact, this is positive for the required domain of 0 to pi by 2. So it simply means that this function f of x is actually increasing function, right? So if it is increasing, let us assume x, which is greater than 0 and lying within this domain, right? Greater than 0, but lying between this domain, or let's say you directly say that x belongs to 0 to pi by 2. So actually, f of x has to be greater than f of 0, clearly because fx is increasing. This is fx, right? So here, f of x is greater than, now let's try to see what is f of 0. So f of 0 is
minus 2.
No, that was not minus 2. That is 2 only, right? Yes. So that is 2 plus 0 plus 1, 3 minus 3. Yes, it is 0. So now from this we have proved that f of x is positive. And what was the f of x? It was part of the derivative of hx, right? So hence x square x is always positive. So it clearly implies that h dash x is positive for x belonging to 0 to pi by 2. Everything that we are doing, x is belonging to 0 to pi by 2 only. So simply, again, we can say for x lying between 0 to pi by 2, we have h of x is greater than h of 0, and h of 0 is clearly 0, right? So we can say that h of x is 2x sec x plus x minus 3 tan x is greater than h of 0, which is this. And this is what we were required to prove actually, right? So this was a question within the question. And the logic was same, the concept was same. We have not used anything else apart from what we have just now covered. So the next question we have, prove that 10x is greater than x plus x cubed by 3 for all x belonging to, again we have 0 to pi by 2. Again, we will be having h of x equals nx minus x minus x cubed by 3, h dash x, which will be secant square x minus 1 minus x square. So this is the h dash x. Now, secant square x we have. So we know that 1 plus 10 square x equals secant square x. So this becomes equal to now in this one, to find out whether 10 square x is greater or actually to prove which one of them is greater, either you can differentiate it once more or we can try to make use of the graph and the other things and some information. So this is 10x minus x, 10x plus x. Obviously this is positive for 0 to pi by 2, right? Now we have to worry about 10x minus x. Now the thing is very simple that 10x minus x, you can assume to be different function. So 10x minus x, g dash x will be equal to secant square x minus 1. Secant square x minus 1 is always greater than or equal to 0. So it simply implies g of x is greater than g of 0 for x belongs to 0 to pi by 2. So clearly g of 0 is 0. So 10x minus x is positive for x belong to 0 to pi by 2. So it clearly implies that h dash x is positive for x belongs to this. And then we can say that h x is increasing for this interval and h of x is greater than h of 0. So 10 of x minus x minus x cubed by 3 is positive for x belongs to 0 to pi by 2. So now you understand that why we had in the beginning when we did the theory, why we have taken this h of 0 always, because this will work in most of the questions, whether you have the constant or not. So ultimately that is going to be very, very helpful in almost all the questions, this h of 0. If not, then we can make the adjustments accordingly. So let's try to write down the next question. And the next question is interesting because it makes use of the other topic, which we already covered, that is LCD. So we have the question, evaluate right, just think about the question and then try to see that how we can relate this. Limit x tends to 0 sine x into tan x divide by x square. And you have been given that x belongs to 0 to pi by 2. X जो है 0 से pi by 2 के बीच में belong कर रहा है. And of course, अब आप सोच रहे होंगे कि ये GIF होगा या नहीं होगा, होगा तो problem हो जाएगी. बिल्कुल है. This box is the GIF. That is greatest integer function. Now with all these conditions, try to find out this limit. So now, in this case, we just need to find out whether this is greater than this or sine x into tan x is greater than x square or not. Because we know that sine x by x, limit x tends to 0 is 1. Tan x by x, limit x tends to 0 is 1. Right. Now, this function inside the box is approaching 1. But we do not know this is approaching 1 from the left-hand side, that is 1 minus, or 1 from the positive side. So we do not know about that. To find out, we need to have a function. Let us say f of x is equal to sine x into tan x minus x square. So we can assume this function. Now again, to find out this is greater than equal to 0 or not, accordingly this will be greater than x square, we'll differentiate. Same procedure. So derivative here will be cos x into tan x plus sine x as it is, then we have sec square x minus 2x. Now this we can simplify a little bit, and here will be sine x plus sine x into sec square x sine x into sec square x minus 2x. Now from here, we cannot exactly predict that this will be positive or not. Of course, we know that this is positive. This is also positive, but here we have minus 2x, right? Now what we can do is, we can try to find out the derivative or derivative of f dash, that is f double dash. So without even thinking, let us try to find out one more derivative. So here we have derivative of sine x as cos x plus cos x into sec square x, and then we will be having plus 2 times. So we have differentiated sine x here. Now we'll differentiate sec x. 2 times sec x into sec x into tan x. And then sine x was already there. And of course, minus 2. Right. Now, from here, we can try to conclude f dash x equals. So we can take something common, that is, if you want to take, we can take the cos x. So here we can take sec x as common, right? So the finally we will be left with, this is cos x and we have minus 2, and then we can, okay, fine, we can simplify this term. So here we will be getting cos x plus, this will be sec x, minus 2 plus this entire thing, that will be 2 times sec square x into tan x into sine x. Now we know that this term is of course positive, This is always positive, right? Now in the this interval 0 to pi by 2, cos x is positive as well as sin x is positive. Both of them are positive. So this expression here, we can write down this expression as root cos x square plus root sec x whole square minus 2 times root cos x into root sec x, which is basically nothing but root cos x minus root sec x whole square. So finally we have proved that this term is positive, right? And we have taken the advantage of that this is in the first quadrant, so we can write down root cos x and root sec x. So this is positive and this is obviously positive. So f double dash x is positive for this interval. So if this is positive, clearly we have the f double dash x positive. So f dash x is increasing. So we can say f dash x is greater than f dash 0. This is f dash x. F dash 0 is clearly 0. So which we can write down f dash x is greater than f dash 0, and f dash 0 is 0. So this is positive. So f dash x is positive. So since this was 0, so f dash x is positive, fx is increasing, which again implies f of x greater than f of 0. F of 0 is 0, right? So we have proved that this is greater than 0, which implies that sine x into tan x greater than x square. Now since x is not equal to 0, we can divide this by x square. So this is what we are having. This is greater than 1. Now we know when x is approaching 0, this entire expression is close to 1, but still greater than 1. So just greater than 1 it will be. So box of anything just greater than 1 is nothing but equal to 1. This is equal to 1, right? So now we just had to find out ki yahan pe ye jo cheez hai sin x by x square, sin x into tan x by x square is approaching 1 from the left hand side or the right hand side. Now we have seen for x positive, this is greater than 1. So when x is approaching 0, very close to 0, that point of time it will still be greater than 1, but just greater than 1 because it is approaching 1, but it's very close to 1, but still it is greater than 1. Let us say 1.0000 and so on, then 1. So box of that quantity is equal to 1 that we already have studied in the greatest integer functions. So the question says, prove that the function, this function, is strictly positive in this interval. So strictly positive means it cannot be even 0, right? It has to be greater than 0. Here we just have to find out, or basically it is, we have to find out something about the function, right? We can find out everything, in fact, about the function using the derivative and the other things. And we have to find out in this interval it is positive. So without even thinking, we know that we have to find out the derivative. So f dash x is equal to 6 x square plus 42 x and minus 60. You can take 6 common. So here you have x square plus 7 x minus 10, right? So 7 x minus 10. So here in this case, you can find out the factors of this, right? So once you find out the factors, then you will have the wavy curve and you will find out where this function is increasing and where this function is actually is decreasing. So here, because the factors will, so just a small change that minus 2x cubed, try to put it minus 2x cubed. So here it will be minus of 6x square and minus of x square. Now the purpose of the question will be fulfilled. you can take minus 6 common, x square minus 7x plus 10, right? Now you try to do this. After this, minus 2x cube. So this can be minus 6 into x minus 5, x minus 2. Then obviously we can have the wavy curve. So here we have 2 and here we have 5. Since there is negative there, so we'll start with negative only, plus minus. Now, before 2, the function is decreasing, right? Because now, according to the question, we just have to work in the interval when x belongs to minus infinity to 1. So when x belongs to this, the function f of x is decreasing. So since f of x is decreasing from minus infinity to 1, so here, let us try to draw the curve of the function. And then we can see what is happening with this. Minus infinity to 1. So let us try to find out f of 1. F of 1 is 21 plus 41, 62, minus 2, minus 60. So that is 0. 62 minus 62, that is 0. So let us say this is x equals 1. And at x equals 1, the value of the function is 0. So function is decreasing from minus infinity to 1. Yeah. Yes. So this will be decreasing and reach this point, right? Of course, after 1 also it is decreasing, but we have to see till x equal to 1 only, right? So we have now this also one conclusion that if function is decreasing in the interval a to b, then f of b will be minimum, right? Okay, fine. So f of b will be minimum. Just remember this thing also because we are going to use it somewhere. So till this point, before that, clearly it is positive, right? From minus infinity to 1, clearly f of x is positive. Strictly positive because we are not taking the value of the function at x equal to 1. We are taking when x is less than 1. So that is when we'll say that fx is strictly positive, not even equal to 0 in that case. So try to take help of the graph in such functions. Let us come to the next question. The next question is very, very interesting. That let us try to see the question. You'll have to find out whether, or we say that which is greater. So we have two functions, or basically two constants, which is greater, e raised to the power pi or pi raised to the power e, right? So it is e raised to the power pi or pi raised to the power e. Which one of the following is greater? Ye bada hai ya ye wala bada hai? We'll try to do it using the increasing and decreasing function only. And we have also solved question based on the inequality. So we are now in a position to solve this question. So in this one, e raised to the power pi and pi raised to the power e. Again, we know that there has to be some functions jinko hum increasing and decreasing proof karke, and we substitute something and then we try to find out which one of them is greater than which one, right? So always do one simple thing. Always, that is equate these functions so that we get an idea what is the function that we can assume, right? Equating in the sense, because we know that both of them are not equal, but let us try to write them parallelly. So e raised to the power pi is there and we have pi raised to the power e, right? Suppose we have taken log on both sides to simplify this actually. So we have ln e raised to the power pi and here we have ln pi raised to the power e. So this becomes pi and this becomes e ln pi, right? This is what we are having, or we can say pi ln a, right? This becomes pi ln a. Now what you do is you rearrange the terms and you write down ln e by e, right? Take e on this side, although they are not equal. I'm just telling you the procedure. Ln pi by pi. Now, if you find out this is greater, then of course you will say that I can say this is greater, and so on. You can move, right? So actually the thing is that you will have to find a relation between this now. So always follow this procedure, that when you have to find out which is greater, write down the terms, try to simplify, multiply by anything on both sides, right? Preferably positive, so that inequality does not change. And here we have taken ln. We know that when base is greater than 1, because log to the base e is greater than log base is greater than 1, inequality will not be affected. Now, assuming this, we have a similarity in the function ln e by e, ln pi by pi. So we have to compare such functions. So from this we get some idea that we can take fx equals ln x by x. This is what we have got. Fx we can assume ln x by x. Now we'll try to prove that this function is increasing or decreasing, right? This is one way of assuming the function. This way will always work. So that is why I try to follow this way. Otherwise, in many of the questions, you will have to assume few functions. So we can differentiate this. We will be having f dash x. Question rule to aata yoga humko. Theek hai. So x into derivative of ln x, 1 by x. And yes, so minus, right? So derivative of x is 1, ln x is as it is, divided by x square. So we have got 1 minus ln x by x square. Now understand one point, that where you have to think, or when this is increasing or decreasing, or when ln x is greater than 1 or when ln x is less than 1. This is the graph of ln x. This was 1, right? So ln x, or here we have e. Ln e is 1, right? This is 1. So clearly, try to find out in the terms of, or in the perspective of the point that you will be putting in, right? You will be substituting e or pi, right? In that interval, you will have to see that function is increasing or the function is decreasing, right? So we are talking about something which is beyond e and pi, right? So after e, let us say for x greater than e, we can say 1 minus ln x is negative, right? Because ln x becomes greater than 1. So function is decreasing. So in this interval, f dash x is negative. So the function is decreasing. Since the function is decreasing, we know that pi, if we have pi, right? Pi is greater than e. Now fx is decreasing. So we can say f of pi is less than f of e, right? Because the function is decreasing in this interval. So f of pi is less than f of e. Now we know that ln pi by pi is less than ln e by e. Now we can solve this thing further, and we can take e on this side and pi on this side. Both are positive. That will not change the thing. So this becomes ln pi raised to the power e less than ln e raised to the power pi. You can take the anti-log, since the base is greater than 1. So inequality will not be affected. So pi raised to the power e is less than e raised to the power pi. Or we can say that this thing is, that is e raised to the power pi is greater than pi raised to the power e. So this is what we have proved. This thing, e raised to the power pi is greater. So again, we have utilized the same thing, same concept. This is one way of finding out the function. Else you can have different kind of functions also, which you can find out depending upon the question. But this thing will work in all the questions. So here we have the question to prove that, or prove that sine of 1 is greater than cos of sine of 1, and this question you will have to do in the homework. So do try to solve this question in the homework. और अभी इतना हो ही जाएगा कि बिकॉज वी हैव सीन मेनी क्वेश्चंस जिसमें ये सब चीजें यूज हो रही हैं, और एक कांस्टेंट वाला ई रेज़ टू द पावर पाई और पाई रेज़ टू द पावर ई वो हम ऑलरेडी कर चुके हैं, ठीक है. सो यू कैन ऑल्सो ट्राई टू सॉल्व दिस विद अ सिमिलर इन द सिमिलर वे दैट वी हैव डन फॉर द रेस्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस, राइट. सो ट्राई टू सॉल्व इट एंड वेट फॉर द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर एंड डू ट्राई टू सी दैट हाउ दिस क्वेश्चन इज बीइंग डन, एंड बिकॉज वी ऑलरेडी नो दैट प्रूफ वी हैव टू प्रूव, सो वी नो दैट साइन ऑफ 1 इज ग्रेटर देन दैट. Right. The only thing is that how we have to assume the function and how we have to make use of the increasing or decreasing functions. Right. So the many things are remaining in this question chapter, that is the Rolle's theorem and LMVT. So there are many things that are left. So we will be covering those topics in the coming classes. So till then, bye bye and take care, and do practice the questions. You have any material along with you, right, or the coaching material or previous questions. So do try to practice if you have watched the video or from any other standard books that you are following, right? So do practice. That is very, very important. Otherwise, in maths particularly, if you do not practice the questions, then you cannot gain the concept very much, right? So after looking at the question, you should promptly find out what I have to do in most of the questions, right? So that is how the practice will play the role. So do practice a lot of questions. So we'll meet up again in the next class. Till then, all of you, bye-bye and take care.